Tyler play the game!
That is an epic fucking intro, dude.
And I have to warn everyone. Warning. What you may see right now is going to be absolutely disgusting.
Sound good?
Alright. That's... sounds good to me.
And welcome to Vestival 2.0. Holy shit. Vestival 2.0. First cheer tongue-tie. The first cheer of today was from Eternal Napalm, who did a 75-bit cheer. And he said, congrats on all of your tremendous success. It's the apocalypse for all the naysayers and detractors. Hashtag BestFest2. Here's the thing. I know they're never going to go away. I know that. As long as I'm a public-facing figure, people who are going to criticize will be there. And again, people with legit criticism, I'm totally okay with. But these crazy conspiracy theorists, these people who hate my guts, all right, they're never going to go away either. They don't even dislike me for legit reasons anymore. At one point, there was. Not anymore. You hear the nonsense they say. It's like, you hate Phil because of a conspiracy theory that's not even confirmed true, you know, or you hate Phil because of some comment he made 10 years ago, and even though every piece of evidence has shown that he's grown as a person, you just hate him anyway. It's like, there's nothing you can do about those people, you know? They're going to be around forever. But that certainly doesn't mean that we haven't seen tons of positive progress around here in the last 3+ months, and I'm so grateful for it, so thank you guys for that.
And by the way, I didn't even mention this, but yes, today is a normal stream, just like any other stream. Today is a normal stream. Yes, there is a vest streak goal here. Give me your money.
The same as always, you know, the same tips goal. And, if we continue it, great. If the vest streak ends today, I'm okay with that too. You know, obviously people want to see it continue. Obviously I'd be very happy if it continued. But at the same time, if this is it, this is it. I even said during the last festival that I thought that was it. I thought it was definitely going to end. But then it didn't. Then it continued. So... just so you guys know, yes, it is a normal stream. There's a normal tips goal and everything here. We'll see what happens.
Give me money, money.
Eternal Napalm Cheater says, you've heard lots of crazy and fringe things from sick people over the years. What deranged conspiracy theory really makes you shake your head in disbelief? Oh my god, jeez. Like, what are the craziest things? When I first started on YouTube, one of the craziest things was the guy who literally said that
I had a cult. Like, I'm brainwashing children to watch my content. Oh my god!
What the fuck? Whoa! Whoa! Don't lose him.
What in the fuck was that, dude?
On YouTube, despite the fact that my content on YouTube was never catered towards children, never, ever did I act in a way that would attract children. It was always adult language, adult content, you know, always was. And was always meant for an adult or teen or adult audience. But this
he legitimately is trying to brainwash children. DSP cult leader. Oh my god.
Like, what the fuck are you talking about? You know, when do I ever stand in front of my audience like a cult leader saying ridiculous things? You know, never. I never did anything like that. I was just a guy playing games.
The bottom line is, guys, I view all of you as independent, intellectual, intelligent individuals who have actively chosen to come on my streams, watch my stuff, and have fun with me. You know what I stand for. You know the kind of person I am. You enjoy either my personality or the way I play games or the rage or whatever. Whatever it may be. You like me for some reason. And you're here to have a good time. And that's all I care about.
That was my whole catch back then. Wow, feels like a normal guy on his couch playing games. That's what we like about his videos. Not that I stand in front of you as some kind of a fucking leader trying to tell you how to live your life and do, you know, that's insane. People believe that. Because they were nuts. Obviously, you know, the one that everyone brings up is the escort saga. The one that was 100% fabricated. 100%. That was one, it didn't even have a root in reality. It didn't even have, you know, I say sometimes people take nuggets of truth and then they turn it into some overblown thing that's not true. That one didn't even have a nugget of truth.
Fuck you. You're a liar.
And of course, you know, recently the one that has been so ridiculous since the beginning of this year is the stupid mobile game nonsense. You know, harping on someone has a name in the game that's the same as my Twitter handle, and somehow that's me. And seeing, you know, I'll be honest. I go over to Kiwi Farms every once in a while when people tell me to, and they like, Phil, I think there's stuff over there you need to know about. It's concerning. And so I went over there a few times to read some of the horrendous bullshit people said about this, and I just read up on it and just completely fabricated nonsense. Like, did I ever play mobile games? Yes. Is there evidence that I've played mobile games? Yes, I've publicly admitted to the mobile games I used to play and whatever, but the fact that these people take that little bit of nugget of truth and turn it into this insanely overblown conspiracy theory that's not true, and then they tried to use that. They literally tried to use that for months to ruin my personal life and screw up my filing for bankruptcy with complete falsified nonsense. None of it was factual, but they tried to convince legal parties to slander against me, which didn't work, thank God, because I had all the evidence to back everything up that I've ever said, and I showed it to the right parties. But that just threw me for a loop. There are people out there who hate me so much that they would fabricate entire things about just crazy shit. I couldn't believe the stuff that was entire. Phil had this conversation with someone about the game. I'm looking at, like, I don't even know who the fuck that is. I've never talked like this before on a chat server somewhere. Like, completely fabricated shit.
The whole year was a lie. I was lying to myself, the viewers, and everyone. Once again, you're being dishonest. And you've shown absolutely no signs of changing. So how is that allowed? That's fucking so dishonest and fucking immoral, in my opinion.
And it completely blew me away that these people are so up their own ass with conspiracy theories, right? Especially after the escort thing. That they would do it again. But they did. But what can I say? What can I say? You know, this is how nuts these people are. I love my wife. Tip me $1.30. And says, you hear they fired the director of the new Assassin's Creed game. He lied about being single to date a girl for a year. She found out he was married and left him. People are weird. Wow. Well, all I can say is that guy sounds incredibly stupid. I don't even know what else to say. That could be one of the dumbest things I've ever heard. That guy's a fucking moron. And obviously he's an immoral piece of shit. And, you know, what goes around comes around, I guess. King Goku says he stepped down. He did not get fired. You know, it's like I said during the whole pro-Jared fiasco, which now apparently has been debunked. I wouldn't know because I didn't even know what he was accused of to begin with. I made a public statement on Twitter. I said, if you're going to fail in life, fail for your content or fail for your work. Don't fail for nonsense of your personal life. You know what I mean? Don't fail because stuff comes out about your character behind the scenes that people can't believe, and now they discredit all your professional work. That was kind of what happened with Pro Jared. I don't think anyone with Pro Jared ever criticized the level of his work. They thought his work was great, but it was his personal crap that got aired out that got him into trouble, right? So here we go. Here's a guy who's the director of the new Assassin's Creed game, which by all reports, the game's looking great, and now this comes out today, and it's like, pfft, how stupid. Why on earth? Would you risk being the director of a major AAA game at a major game studio that's probably going to be a blockbuster game by being an asshole? Maybe just don't be an asshole, right? But I guess it's too hard for some people.
Pretty hypocritical, I agree.
If we do hit a 200 vest streak, all right, which I'm not expecting, I'm not asking, I'm just saying if we do, because you guys have already blown me away, 3 months of positivity that I never expected. If we hit a 200 vest streak, yes, that will be the next festival celebration.
Oh my God. Disgusting beggar.
So, all that being said, I have a special message that I would like to read from a fan a few months ago that I never really revealed, okay? So, I'm not going to tell you guys the name of the person or anything like that. I'm just going to read you their message, okay? They said, the first playthrough that I ever watched of yours was your co-op playthrough of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Turtles in Time Reshelled way back when in 2009. Back then, I was just 11 years old, and now I'm actually 22. I've been a fan ever since. While I don't have as much time to watch your videos on YouTube or catch your streams on Twitch anymore, I do my best to still support and pop in whenever I can. The reason that I'm sending you this email is very simple. I hope this is an okay way of reaching you. Of course it was. It's to say thank you. The last decade, you've provided me with so many laughs, and those laughs have gotten me through some of the toughest times of my young life. I was an avid user of your original King of Hate forums way back in 2010, and actually I met my now lifelong best friend in the forum chat, who I still talk to on a nearly daily basis to this very day. Without you, that connection would never have been made. I would never have met her, so absolutely, I must thank you for that.
Yeah.
As well, and I know she would be thankful as well.
You've also been a huge motivational inspiration over the past decade. Oh my god! That was great! Oh my god!
With all of the unwarranted garbage and harassment that you've been subjected to on a daily basis, you've never given up. A full decade later, through all the turmoil, you're still here doing what you love, and that's incredibly commendable. You taught me that no matter what, you can't ever give up. You can't give in, and you certainly can't let anyone or any group of trolls force you to quit something. Thank you for this lesson. I'm also happy for you that you've been able to find love with Kat, and I'm glad that you two are able to wed and you're doing well, and I wish you both the absolute best moving forward. I apologize not having much more to offer you than a few kind words, and I feel compelled to reach out to you and to say thank you. Whether you realize it or not, you make huge waves in the world, and many of them are positive ones. The internet loves to focus on negativity, but you've actually done great things. You've pioneered trends that now dominate YouTube, and that's something you should forever wear as a badge of honor, whether the majority of people choose to recognize that or not. We've all made mistakes, and none of us are perfect. But if no one else has ever told you this, despite all, you're a good man, Phil. I appreciate you in every second of your life you shared with us via YouTube, Twitch, etc. over the past decade. Rest assured, there are people in the world who know of your name and recognize that you're not a villain, that so many people attempt to make you out to be. I'll always be a fan, I'll always respect you and what you've done, and what you'll know that you'll always be a legend in the world of entertainment to me. Keep going as long as you can. Above all else, be sure that at the end of the day that you're happy. Love and appreciate you, man. Take care. And the reason that I read that to you guys is
because I just want you guys to understand that that means the world to me when I get a message like that. Like, it's been tough. You know, my life has been tough over the last decade. It has. And when I read a message like that, I'm sorry that I'm tearing up like a baby. But when I read a message like that, it makes me feel like it was worth it. You know, like, all the shit that happened to me and all the stress and the mental shit that I go through on a daily basis sometimes, that is worth it because there's people out there who got something out of all of this. You know, it wasn't just some dickhead in front of a camera, you know, doing stupid videos, that it actually meant something to people. And that means the world to me, that there's people out there that, you know, for a decade, that they've been watching me, and they've been following me, and they've been watching my life evolve and how I've become a better person, you know? You know, admittedly, when I started, I did so many stupid things that, you know, I didn't realize were stupid. And now I've grown and matured, especially the last 3 to 4 years. I've changed as a person and a content creator. And I realize now, you know, we have things going on in the world right now with Black Lives Matter and stuff. And you look back at the stuff that I've done, I'm like, man, I was an idiot with the stuff that I said and did. Not caring about, you know, if anyone was offended or hurt by the stuff that I did, because there was thousands of people watching me, you know. And I actually, now when I get an email like that, all right, it makes me feel like people grew with me. But that kind of message right there, that makes it all worthwhile. It does, like that, it touches me, and it makes me know that, you know, there are people who get it. That there are people who get it. They understand who I am and what I'm about and why I've done this as long as I have and why I'm still doing it and I'm not going to give up doing it, you know? Thank you for that. Thank you so much. That message, I saved that purposely for months until I felt it was the right time. And I hope that you guys, So I really feel, I've told you guys, the whole King of Hate moniker, the reason it came to be is because I felt that when people hated on me, okay, when people hated on me, that was a motivation for me to do better and to persevere. And this message right here is saying, yeah, that's exactly what they got out of me. That no matter what people threw against me, that I don't give up, and it's helped them in the last 10 years to get through shit in their life. That means something. So thank you guys who stuck with me. Thank you, you know what I mean, and supported me so much. I appreciate it so much. It does mean a lot to me, okay? Phil has indoctrinated children who send him money, blatantly milking for money. It's a money pit. It's gone, just gone, like that, in an instant, fucking gone. I just care about money. That I just can't help it. I eBay. Contributions are mandatory. But I need your help. I am appealing directly to you. No decency, no respect, no common sense, no fucking maturity. It's the guy who just doesn't get reality.